know what you're wondering. Where did I find a shipwreck to take this bottle from? But here's the secret. That's our craft for today, is making these awesome, really fun, cheap, customizable shipwreck bottles. With Halloween around the corner, you may want this as a prop for your party, or if you're me, as just part of your normal house decor, because it looks super cool. It just adds some extra flair when you're decorating and you happen to have a pirate themed room. This is a really fun craft to do. It does have to come in stages though, so you can't make it the day of, you have to plan ahead. It's just really fun to put it together and see a pile of junk turn into an awesome decoration piece like this. Anyway, enough talking. Let's get to it. The first thing you will need for this project is a bottle. I use wine bottles, you can use juice bottles, you can use whatever kind of bottles you would like. And then you just have to remove the label that's on there. I soak mine in soapy water for a little bit and then just use a pot scraper to scrape it off. And the beauty of this project is because we're going to be covering it in stuff, it doesn't need to be perfectly smooth to begin with. For the first stage, set up a plate or bowl that has some Mod Podge or a glue and water mixture and then saturate some paper towels. Then just use these saturated paper towels and plaster them all around the bottle wherever you would like. We're basically just adding a base for our texture here. Again, make sure it's very saturated so that it's nice and sticky and will stick to the glass and can also hold up some weight. Here is my pile of junk, which is going to turn into treasure pretty soon. I have an assortment of seashells, coins, beads, bottle caps, random charms, key rings, all sorts of random things. After the paper towel base has become a little bit dry, so it's more tacky than wet, just add a top layer of glue or Mod Podge. Then I start securing the decorations. And now the reason I put on such a thick layer of paper towel is so that I can stick the decorations inside of it and just use that to secure it a little more. Plus then that gives it the effect of having been infused into the crustacean gunk stuff. Just make your way all around the bottle, adding in your little pieces of fun. And yes, you can use whatever you want. All we're going for here is texture, texture, and more texture. So my beads are purple, my bottle cap is green, and that's fine because we're just going to paint over it. You can do it side by side or you can do the whole thing at once and stand it up to dry. But basically, now you're going to let the entire thing dry completely, which may be a couple hours or you can just leave it overnight. Now it's time for the painting. The two paints I use are a dark brown and this greenish color. And then I just mix them up together and I make them in pretty small batches. That way I can have lots of very similar but not the same brown colors. That just adds a little bit more dimension and makes it look less uniform. Another technique to use is to just splotch some paint on there and then dab around with a paper towel. And the reason I use a paper towel to spread it instead of a paintbrush or something is just, again, to make it less even and give it more texture. After it dries, this is what it looks like. You can see it definitely has that under the sea type of look going on, just because it has all of those different textures and browns and that ugly sea green color. If you want to stop there and leave your shipwreck bottle as it is, that's totally fine. It's up to you how you want to leave it. But for me, I'm just going to add a little bit more unique personality to it. So I'm blending another brown and green color and making it thicker using Mod Podge. And then I'm just going to sort of drool it over part of my bottle. Just again, I don't know what kind of weird gunk has gotten on this thing, but I'm sure there's some gross sea gunky liquid that could just be oozing all over this bottle and give it some more texture. I don't know. It's just one of those fun things I like to do. Sometimes I just put a layer of gloopy hot glue over it and put paint on top of that. Have some fun with it. Really, there's no way you can do it badly because you can just cover it up with some more paper towels and paint if you really mess it up. This is all about having fun and getting creative. Thanks guys so much for watching my video. If you enjoyed it or you got inspired, please give me a thumbs up. Maybe check out the other videos I have on my channel. If you go ahead and try it, please, please, please let me know how it goes. Maybe post a picture of it because I would love to see how you guys bring some regular bottles to life.